Pa-start na in a while.
In a while.
Alam mo naman tayo, in a while. Nagpa-apps pa eh. Sa kagali, this world. Ano ba yung press ko?
Hindi na. Puno lang siya. Kasi nag-help ako sa kanya ko sa candidates.
Glam. Kaya dapat dito yan. Nung nalaman na 16, kaya niya dinala ng glam. Kasi 16 years old.
Good evening, everyone. It starts at $15. The first presentation is about to begin in uno, dos, tres.
Sabi ko na siya. Si Amir.
Mabay dyan, sobrang bay dyan.
Wala akong mag-blend. Eh, baka naman puro overrated. Kaya... may mga overrated na naka-live. Ha? Wala, wala ako. Wala raw nakapit.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the press presentation of Iloob Pilipinas. Tonight, you will meet the 22 gentlemen, or Iloob, I should say, who will vie for the four titles on stake this year. On Sunday, four of them will bring home the titles of Iloob Pilipinas Mr. Universe Tourism, Iloob Pilipinas Man of the Year, Iloob Pilipinas Gentlemen of the World, and Iloob Pilipinas Mistress of the World. The 22 candidates will come out first in their newly released Simone Swimwear. Swimwear? After which they will all come out in their identical Iloob Pilipinas shirts for everyone to appreciate. That's this is such a good batch of candidates, I can assure you.
I agree with you, Norman. So shall we start? Are you all ready?
Are you ready, Nadine? Have you memorized your names right now?
I will soon, I promise. All right.
But before we actually start, we would just like to thank our co-presenter, Coro Hotel, one of the best boutique hotels in Makati City. I love this hotel. Super. I love the rooms, I love the pool area, I love the people. And of course, this Institute of Beauty, headed by the, where is that? The very Bruce Lee, Nick Soriano, who's going to be a Mrs. 2020 soon. Yeah. So are the boys ready now? Boys, are you ready? Good.
Start off with candidate number one, Mantaluyo. Albert
being a nurse, he He wants to be a doctor someday. Use an extortion. store manager for a popular clothing store, where he is now proudly representing Bulacan and wants to also represent the Philippines internationally.
Candidate number 15, Osamis, Romar Tatura.
Romar, he is an excellent bartender who runs his own bar in Osamis City. If you want good gin and cocktails, then take the matter. But his parents preferred that it be spelled Sandy instead.
Candidate number 17, Makati, Jomar Maji.
Jomar may represent Makati, but he's also proud in the proud Mindoreño. Thank you. shirt and jeans before we start the open Q&A. Let us also discuss about upcoming events. Tomorrow, the Catholics will have their pool party. I love Coro Hotel. Tomorrow, we'll have a pool party upstairs.
Yes, we were actually taking the swimsuit pictures there. Had a really nice atmosphere.
Hey guys, the swim party show is very exciting.
Very,
very exciting. And also, they have their. And before the final on Sunday, they'll be the next competition.
Saturday.
Tomorrow is the pool party. Saturday is the costume competition. Sunday is the finals. For four of them will win. By the way, since our main industry first tourism Philippines is here, why don't we invite him to join us today?
Yes.
Kelvin.
To our guests, good evening, and please do support, you know, Pilipinas for your coronation on Sunday.
Well, do you want to say anything to the boys?
Boys?
To the Ginoo
all around. I thought you called them boys. For me, they are gentlemen of our future generation, and to be our role model for you know, Pilipinas, Mr. Universe Tourism Philippines.
I'm happy with your reign so far.
Very happy in my reign because I just did not do or achieve my objectives as Mr. Universe Tourism. I had my tree planting, I had my organic farming, I had my organic product endorsing as well as healthy ambassadors as well. And I had also traditional, and I have fashion shows including what about immersion in the Mindanao, Palawenos, in Palawan, Puerto Princesa.
So what does the future lie ahead for Kelvin?
What lies for me is that I hope to bring back the international title here in the Philippines, the Mr. Universe Tourism. And if I won this international pageant, I will continue to inspire our younger generation. Their goals high and planning for ahead for their future. Yes.
Thank you so much. Now, I think guys are already in their official shirt and jeans, and they'll be ready to face the members of the media again, where we will open the floor for your questions. We are currently on MV. Right, Mia? Maria, we're live right now, yeah. And Auntie also, we're live. Yeah. We're live. Maria, we're live, Maria. Are the Ginoos, brother? Are they ready to step out on stage again? Ready? By the way, if you're definitely live and some questions that some of the viewers would like to ask, feel free to ask some of the candidates.
Again, we would like to thank our sponsors.
Our sponsors, a very, very nice Coro Hotel. What does Coro mean again? It's united in harmony. It's very nice. I like the rooms, I like the whole area. I will stay here again very soon. I wish. And also Nix Institute of Beauty with a beautiful Nix Soriano will be a Mrs. 2020 something. Yeah. She will choose her title now. Of course you know me. It's like boys, are you ready?
Yes.
Good. So please step out. In your official shirt and jeans, for the members of the media so that they can look at you. Albert Shiwani Sipri, 18, from Mandaluyong.
Representing the city of Baguio. Antonio, Barry Passion Mariano.
Naimbag marabi kanyayo amin, or should I say, good evening to everyone. I'm John Amidones, 20, representing Pangasinan.
Jordan Suyu Sipaduka, 23, Ginoong Cagayan Valley.
Good evening, everyone. Cliff Robert Kasumpak, 24, from the land of the famous Banawi Rice Services. Ifugao!
So maybe as Sir Norman mentioned earlier, one of my passions is that I like to look at supercars. So that's one thing that the media might not know. And another thing is that I love to swim a lot. So, because I grew up along the beach, so I love swimming. And so that, those are two random facts about me.
Thank you. But I'm
I think maaari niya rin po akong makilala sa pamagitan po ng social media. And also, active po ako sa social media. I also do like joining pageant. And I think na mas makikilala niyo po ako sa darating po na pageant na Ginoong Pilipinas 2019. As you can see me in different categories. And also sa darating po na question and answer.
Good evening. By the way, I'm Ivan Francisco Las Piñas, and I want to be remembered as someone who is passionate and hard work. At a young age, I managed to run my own business, and that's it. I love traveling and surfing. So, to my supporters, you can message me or talk to me. I'm very much welcome to entertain you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, I want to call Miss Osami.
Thank you, boys. Please go back to the line.
Yeah, Osami's Miss Osami. It's all right. Yeah, I also want to call Mandaluyo and Makati. Okay, I just want to know if you have your own personal advocacy. Although it sounds like cliche, but I just want to know for a guy like you. Personal advocacy. I just want to know if you have your own personal advocacy. Although it sounds cliche, but I just want to know from like there is really, you know, you're into it.
Hello po, good evening po. I have a personal advocacy, same lang nung sumali ako sa first pageant ko with Mr. Spilbinas. Advocacy po is for education. Yes, for education po sa kabataan Pilipinas.
Sa akin naman, gusto ko yung mga tao na magiging positive sa mga kanilang mga buhay at hindi yung puros negative na lang kasi pangit yun eh. Dapat positive, di ba? Thank you.
Para po sa akin ang advocacy ko is be humble. Kung may narating ka na or may proud ka na, huwag kang magmataas. Gawin mo yung proud mo na tumulong ka sa ibang tao. Kung may nalalaman ka or may tumulong ka sa ibang tao na mas mababa sa iyo na yung mga nalalaman mo. So yun.
Thank you guys. Just want you to follow Mythology for updates in your photos and pictures. Thank you.
Yes, good evening. I would like to ask Cavite, Aspate, and Bulacan. Good evening. Gusto ko lang malaman kung ano yung mga preparations mo before joining this pageant and what are your expectations from this pageant? You can start, Kavita. Tinong kami.
My preparation ko is nag-aaral ko ako ng mga posibleng maging positive questions sa mga narating na contest. At natutin ko ako ng mga runaways kung paano ko tumatawag ng mga model ko. And then, disiplina po sa pagtulog, pagkain, at sa sarili. Salamat po.
Okay.
So, our preparation is a little bit hard for us. We had a hard time because we only given 29 days before the national pageant starts. So we practice on the possible questions and Q&As for me to answer. To each category, we had a series of practices, especially for the round in swimwear, national costumes, and all that. And my mentor told me and taught me to have a confidence in myself to know how to carry myself in the public, especially on the limelight or in the big stages. Because it's my first time to be in a national pageant, so maybe I have the least experience of them all, but I'm doing my best to compete and to win the crown.
Hi po, good evening. Ang preparation ko po sa before the pageant is diet, workout, then nag-aral na mabuti para sa Q&A. Then yung expectation ko is to bring home the crown, to bring to Bulacan the crown. Thank you.
Okay, may I have the youngest so far? Three of the youngest. Okay, my question is for the two of you. Being the youngest so far, what has been your greatest achievement so far?
Good evening, everyone. For me, the greatest achievement so far that I had is by joining this pageant. This is really a great pageant, and not everyone can join this pageant. We really did a lot for us. We really did a lot preparation to join this pageant, and I committed my time myself, and I hit the gym, and I did my diet because I have to lose weight because we only have like 29 days for proper preparation. So yeah, I think joining this pageant is one of my greatest achievements. Thank you.
My achievement, yung pinaka-biggest ko is yung matupad ko po yung isa pong dream ko is yung ano po, ito po, yung makasali po ako sa ganitong pageant na hindi na pinaghihirapan ng iba na ngayon ako nandito nakikita nyo. Happy ako na naabot ko na yung isa sa mga pangarap ko and gagawin ko tong treasure na
thank you. One last more for the pageant veterans naman. Cagayan Valley, La Union, and Las Piñas. So, alam namin na nagpa-pageant talaga ever since. So, what have you been learned from joining pageant?
First things first, but the first thing that I learned from my past pageants until now is always trust yourself. And most of all, always put God first in everything you do. And for the first, lately, I've been losing myself, but true rules are all there. Through that reminder, that always be yourself. I am really touched. See, that is what I really need. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Bob. In joining such competition, I have learned to have a helping hand that will help and touch others. People's lives, and second, I have the strong mind for me to be able to pursue my advocacy, and lastly, I have a good heart that will inspire other people. Thank you.
So the things that I've learned during my previous pageant is that I gained more experience, I gained self-confidence, and most importantly, I had to believe and trust myself that if you believe in yourself, nothing can go wrong. And never let other people judge or put you down. Always rise above and do your best. That's it. Thank you.
Hello. Did mom something happen?
Wait, I'm sorry. Maria Edge, Deloria Quadro.
Hello. Hello. Good evening, guys.
Very important to have a pinili niya, di ba?
I wanna call Mr. Ozamis. Yung jowa mo, di ba? Chaba. Mr. Ozamis, and then Mr. Masabate. Sino ba yung medyo malalayo ng ano? Ibuka. Kagayan ba? Okay, one of the titles in Ginoong Pilipinas is Mr. Universe Tourism. Tama ba dito, Norms? So, tourism. So, paano mo ako i-convince to fly in your proud hands? Nakasama. Mr. Azamis. So, how can you convince me here?
Maria Edge.
Okay. To travel in Azamis.
Daming mga guwapo ko doon.
Ano raw?
Mababait yung mga tao doon, tapos mayroon kami mga tourist spot. Like the oldest pipe organ, yung may Gota Fort. Yes, and may ano kami, parang one of the longest zip line sa Asia, yung Hyomay.
Sasamahan mo ko lang, Ivo?
Of course.
Ah! Sorry. Thank you. And Mr. Almospate? Ayan. Paano ko i-convince na mag-travel sa Masbate?
First of all, ma-convince ko po kayo because Masbate can offer a lot of, in terms of tourist spots, cultural and historical heritage, and of course, the people or the Masbateños itself. So, Masbate is not known or very underrated place because of they think that Masbate can offer anything. But the truth is, Masbate has a lot of beaches, white beaches, falls, natural resources that can help and utilize us to increase the arrivals here in the Philippines. Maybe if we help or the organization or the government in Masbate will focus on developing its resources. For example, the Rodeo Capital. I mean the Rodeo held in Masbate yearly. It's one of the highlights of the Masbate, and you will be happy if you go there.
So, pwede po sa masa ng rodeo?
It's my pleasure.
Sorry. And last?
Simply I can invite you, willingly invite you to Cagayan Valley by simply sharing you my experience, one of the greatest experiences.
Like Queen, because it is a very emotional song and it's such a diverse and it shows so many different aspects of the song, and I think that I can do the same in this pageant. I can show so many different emotions and I can show different kinds of myself that I can express to everyone.
Sound fun?
Unfortunately, I'm not a good singer.
Thank you so much and good luck. Thank you.
Any other questions? Jonas, you have a question, I'm sure.
Hi,
yes, I believe me. I'd like to ask Real Talk and Doro and Tino in the city, please. Okay, can you guys describe to us your definition of a typical Hinata Pinoy?
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for coming tonight. For me, the typical description of Binatang Pinoy is hard work, Filipino heart, and self-belief. Because I believe that if you have those three, you represent
Team Filipino. Yala ba?
For me, the typical binatang Pinoy is someone who is a man of influence, who can actually create an impact in the lives of other people. Although right now, of course, our
refugees here at Binom Filipinas. And then my question for, okay, let's call Cebu, Ifugao. What do you think would be the qualities that would make you stand out among the other candidates? And also, what's your opinion in...
I think the qualities that will make me stand out the most is that I'm an overall package. Because I think that I have the height, the looks, and the ability to speak, to be able to convince everyone that I could be a good representative in an interview.
Guys on social media who keeps displaying their bodies.
Well, I believe that people who have worked hard for their body should be able to display it if they choose to, because social media is a medium. They should feel free to do so. Okay, that's all. Okay.
Good evening, everyone.
Alright.
The qualities that can make me actually myself, confidence in myself, and have faith in God. Well, having a good attitude is very important because you must need to know the to respect other cultures, because in this pageant we have a lot of provinces joining, and of course we need to respect each and every one of the candidates. And I'm very kind to one of everyone, and of course faith in God. Because having faith in God, we must believe in ourselves.
Stand out is, as what Tsuko also said, is my face, my looks, and my height, and also the dedication that makes me
be about guys who display their bodies on the social media accounts.
As much as wala silang tinatapakang tao at kaya nila ipakita yung sarili nila at proud sila sa sarili nila, wala namang problema ko. Yun lamang ko.
Okay, thank you guys.
Regarding the question for my opinion on social media, I forgot to answer that, I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay.
Alright, for me, I just don't mind the bashers on social media. We just need to accept it because we are in this kind of industry, and of course acceptance and understanding is the most actual or quality that we need to have. And of course we need to be confident every time. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you guys.
Question, Patrice.
Gusto mo pa?
Go, sir. Good evening, everyone. I would like to call on Sir Osamis and Mr. Su. I'm going to ask you my questions. Okay, let's start with Mr. Su. This is a question. Okay? Let's say, for example, that birds can think and speak like humans or humans do. And it means that aircrafts are intruders in their territory. As a pilot, how would you convince that it is not?
Could you repeat the question, sir? It's not very clear.
Sure. Okay, so let's say, for example, that birds can think and speak like humans do. Okay, and they are thinking that aircrafts are intruders in their territory. Okay, as a pilot, how would you convince them that it is not?
Can you repeat the part about after the words? If words could speak?
Yeah, if words can speak and think, and they
birds?
Think, yes, birds.
Okay.
Okay, and they think that aircraft are intruders, and as a pilot, how would you convince them it is not?
So, well, if birds could speak, and aircrafts are not intruders. So, for me, I think the main thing that I would, that projectable design, and it is made to fly, just like the birds. So I'm sure that the birds would be able to say, wow, that's another big bird who's flying at me. That's all.
For example, you are a dish that will, if you're a dish,
okay,
that will best represent the Philippines to the world, the international diners, what will be your ingredients and what will it taste like?
I'm sorry, ano yung...
Okay, pagkain.
Alechon.
Okay.
Alechon po.
Okay, ano yung ingredients mo at ano yung lasa mo? Will it be sweet or sizzling hot?
So, prefer ko yung ano, yung sweet tas spicy. Kasi kahit ano, masarap naman yun, di ba?
Self-respect is very important, so I'll go for handsome na tapos may respeto pa sa kapwa. Yan po.
Before I ask a question, I would like to ask, how old are you?
I'm 19 years old.
19 teenager. Okay, so the question is, do you think unwed teenage fathers should receive compensation from the government? Okay. Do you think unwed teenage fathers should receive compensation from the government?
Tagalog daw.
Do you think you should receive the compensation, either in financial form, whatever, from the government? Kasi nga, no interest.
Kung maging batang sumakagaw, Clark, abutis ka na maaga, dapat pa daw makatanggap ka ng tulong mula sa gobyerno dahil doon sa kalagayan yun.
Siguro, kailangan pa rin po kasi nabataan po tayo, so dapat lang po nasuportahan tayo ng ating mga gobyerno. Kahit ito po ay naging kamalian, so dapat po bigyan po ng pagkakataon na may tama. Hindi po ito sigaan o dapat maging aral pa. Maraming salamat po.
Any more questions before the phone-in question? Because there's a phone-in question for Benguen, Zambales. Perry, did you answer that? Perry Baguio. John Lam. Miguelito and Elmer. Line up kayo dito, please. Because we want na lahat sila marinig ang mga voice nyo, those na tinawag ko. Okay. The question, the phone-in question is, kung makakapili daw kayo ng title ng papanalunan on Sunday, anong title yon at bakit? If you can choose a title that you will win on Sunday night, what title will it be and why? Briefly lang ha, anim kayo sasagot. Let's start with Michael and Beckett.
If I have given the chance to choose one crown that I will win this coming Sunday is whatever fits me the most to represent our country. The crown that makes me stand out and prove
prove that even though I have anxiety and depression, I can show the world that we people who have this, who stutter and feel broke inside, that we can achieve our goals and dreams if we work hard and believe in ourselves. Thank you.
Hello, Mike. I'm going to start with the title. Sandy.
Kung papipiliin lang po ako, tulad po ng sinabi niya, kung saan po ako mag-feed. Pero kung may pagkakataon po, I think a man of the world. Man of the year po, ito po yung, because I have an experience po for modeling and I'm an optimistic person po na laging iniisip and I'm looking for positive vibes para po, at kung pagbibigyan mo po ako na maging man of the year, and I will do my best po para po mag-represent sa international to compete para po kung ano pa yung may offer ng Pilipinas sa kanila. Thank you.
If I would be choosing a title, that would be a Mr. Tourism, because I have this advocacy promoting environmental awareness, which is now in timely relevant to my city, which is Baguio City, because we are suffering a lot of problems like cutting off trees, pollution, and that's why I want to become a voice to change this. Thank you.
Good evening. If I were to choose one title, I would choose Mr. Universe Tourism, because I want to showcase our beautiful Philippines to other countries, that even if we don't go out to other countries, our Philippines is still beautiful, and we can still use our tourist pass to encourage them to visit the Philippines and stay here as long as they can. That's all. Thank you.
Apat ang titles, ha? Universe Tourism, Man of the Year, Gentleman of the World, Mistress of World. Okay?
First of all, good evening everyone. If I were to choose a title on October 27, it would be Mr. Universe Tourism, because me, as a pageant UP, I want to inspire other youth like me to focus on their personality, their inner side, not on their physical looks, how big they are. So how I want to influence others to become confident in their own selves. Thank you.
Hey everyone. If I'm going to choose one title, it will be Man of the Year. Because I'm aiming here to compete high title, and I will choose this because I want to promote my use my voice to promote my advocacy to the Haida community, which is the importance of empowering education to education. And I want to show the beauty of our country, which is the Philippines, and I want to be to inspire other people. That's all, thank you.
Big question from Bob. Mr. Cherry Rose from Pink. Do you think you have a question for our candidates, please?
I'd like to ask Cebu. Oriental in the world. Good evening. Why join pageants? What do you think is the relevance para sa inyo?
I think it's important to join pageants like this because for me, I believe that pageants is a way to empower our youths, be it a man or a girl. And for me, it is a platform for self-expression, so it's very important. Thank you.
pageants lately is because I think it is a stepping stone to bigger things. So each time I join something, I'm able to reach further. And not only that, pageants are not just a platform for entertainment, but they're also a platform to be able to talk about what you believe as an individual. And that is why pageants have advocacies. So personally, my advocacy is anti-racism and discrimination, as I've made known during my spoken poetry. So together with the fact that we can use our platform to make our voices heard, and also that, that I think that I can reach bigger opportunities through pageants. That is the reason why I've been joining pageants, and that is why I think pageants are really relevant nowadays.
Okay, so I'll give a question.
Hello, good evening. My name is Jenner from Blitz in Glamour. So this question is for anyone who wants to answer the question. So my question is, as a candidate of Ginoong Pilipinas 2019, what can you bring to the table in promoting the pageant? Okay, Mr. Sibo, thank you for volunteering. So once again, the question is, what can you bring to the table in promoting the pageant Ginoong Pilipinas 2019?
So I'm assuming this is if I was to bag one of the titles, or to this pageant itself.
Possible, or even though you're going to win or not, but what would be the thing that you can bring?
Well, as we all know, it's Ginoong Pilipinas, meaning we're representing something from the Philippines, and each of us here are representing a region of the Philippines. So I myself, I represent Cebu. So one of the things that I will bring to the table is to bring the culture of Cebu and make it more known, such as the Christianity that was brought in Cebu. As we all know, Christianity was brought in Cebu first before it spread, and that is one of the reasons why the Philippines is a Christian country. But on top of that, Cebu has a lot of beautiful culture, such as it has beautiful beaches to offer. It has a lot of tourist spots, churches, as well as there's a lot of ecotourism. One example of this is Oslo whale watching. And then the more thing is the Habon Nueva, which I really like to promote, because Habon Nueva is woven by the women in Argao, Cebu, which is made locally. So we have to support local because this is a pageant that we're doing in the Philippines. So we might as well do our best to promote what each and every one of our regions have to offer.
Alright, thank you, Mr. Cebu. So it entails that we're going to promote tourism industry, especially in Cebu. Thank you.
What could I bring to this pageant since I am a candidate is the core values, which is pagiging makajos. The candidate must be have faith on God, and then pagiging makatao, which is being respect to your co-candidates and to the people surrounds you. And then pagiging malikasan, which is one of the most advocacies that I have, which is promoting environmental awareness. And then lastly would be pagiging makabansa. And then I'm not representing also my city, but also representing the country. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Thank you for the question. Coming from Oriental Mindoro, the influence that I would like to share with you guys is I want to start this advocacy that we should treat our indigenous people better, because I have seen the indigenous people in Mindoro, we call them again, there are somehow mistreated, or most of the time they're mistreated. So that would be my influence, that would be something that I would bring to the table. And my appearance, you can look at me, and for example, if you're giving me a chance to represent our country internationally, you can recognize that I'm a Filipino. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
So what I can bring to the table is that I want to encourage encourage the people, especially the youth, to join pageant like this, because this is a great platform for you to showcase what you can do to the people, especially their family, their friends. Show them that you can do something in life, and this is a really great experience, and this is a great achievement as well. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. For me, what I can offer to the Filipinas is myself. My voice in influencing everyone in promoting whatever the focus of Filipinas is, and of course, our rich cultures that we need to promote and to preserve. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. So, my answer to the question of what I can give to the tables in this pageant is that, of course, our culture and, of course, the Masbateños itself. Because I believe that the voice of individual or each and every one of us can be only heard if we are given an avenue or opportunity. And I think this is the right avenue and opportunity for us to voice out, to be heard by a lot of people and to be listened by a lot of people, rather than having only posting such in social media. So I can use this platform, of course, to encourage Masbateños to be confident in themselves. Of course, because as you can see, Masbate is not so active in terms and pageantry at all. And I am here to prove that no matter how small you think you are, no matter what people might think about you, as long as you have the passion, the determination, and the courage to do the things you love, there is nothing impossible, and we can reach the greater heights we want to have. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I want to be a voice to everyone. For those students who is hardworking, just push yourself to graduate. And if no one's going to believe you, just believe in yourself. That's my advocacy. And as a candidate of Pinoy Pilipinas, that's all the words that I can say on those students, and just push yourself to graduate. If no one's going to believe you, just believe yourself, you can do it. That's all, thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Michael Baez. As I said, I was diagnosed with severe anxiety and depression. And what I can contribute in this project is to inspire the people having this illness as me, because for me, Having this illness is not living anymore, it's surviving. And I do believe that if we believe in ourselves and in our strengths, in our capabilities, and ask the help of God, we can do anything we want. I want to use this as my platform also to showcase my advocacy, which is mental health awareness, especially today that a lot of youth is depressed and taking their life. I want to show them that there is still hope, that we can achieve our dreams if we believe in ourselves. Thank you.
Good evening, Paul. I think, Paul, I understand pageantry is not just about grades and glamour, that after the spotlight is over, it is really about ourselves and how we really exude that positive attitude to other people. And I believe that we Filipino men have so much to offer in the international arena, that we are more than just the looks. We also have the attitude, we have that character in each one of us, that we can achieve greater heights in lives, that we are man of honor, intellect, and substance. And I think it's time that we use this platform to really inspire so much in their education, that we have talent to offer to the international arena. And I think that are the very same elements that I can offer to the table. As a fourth-year law student of Law Students of the Philippines, I'd like to use this platform to bring change to the Philippines. Thank you.
Okay. I'm going to ask you a question about the parliament. I'm going to throw a curveball. Napapagod namin sa question.
talaga. The question is, why is it important for you to win Ginoong Pilipinas?
Okay, thank you, Tito. Why is it important to me to win Ginoong Pilipinas? This I will use Ginoong Pilipinas as a medium for me to be able to pursue my advocacy, which is the mental health awareness. Because I myself is a living testament that I suffered from depression, and I did not hesitate to ask guidance and advices from my parents, to the people around me, and to my friends. And with that, I surpassed. So I want to encourage the youth who's suffering from depression to just, I am open to them. If they need to someone to talk to, or someone will ask them for prayer, I am willing to help them. This is for their betterment. Thank you.
For me, winning this competition, the first thing is I will show the world, I will show the country what a real Ginoo is. That real Ginoo is not about having a good face, having a good body, having the faith. It's not about what you have, but it's all about what you can give. So about that. It's all about the knowledge that you can share, the skills that you can teach, and the value that you can give to everyone. The respect that you can cater to every single citizen of the Philippines. Thank you.
Good evening. I want to pursue my advocacy, which is education, because there's a lot of Filipino, especially kabataan Filipino, na hindi talaga kapag-aral sa panahon din. And syempre, nandungan pa rin ako sa kasabi ni Dr. Jose Rizal na ang kabataan pa rin po talaga ang pag-asa ng bayan. Thank you. Can you repeat the question?
Bakit ka pinakalangan sa akin? Why is it important for you to win Ginoong Pilipinas?
For me, it is important to win for Ginoong Pilipinas. For me to have a sense of achievement and fulfillment in life. Likewise, the excitement that I'm experience here and the memories that I make here with my candidates is work beyond in measuring my in work beyond in widening my social horizon and understanding people. And of course, it is a privilege for me to promote my advocacy, which is focusing on HIV and AIDS awareness, which is very rampant nowadays. I know that HIV and AIDS awareness is a very sensitive issue. But the real problem here is not about the virus, but the ignorance of the medical. And as an advocate, I will push to have for proper knowledge of having HIV and AIDS. Thank you.
Finally, Clark.
My advocacy in life is tulungan po yung mga batang nagsara dahil karamihan po sa kanila ay lumayas po sa kanilang mga tahanan. Dahil hindi po sila napapakain na sapat ng kanilang mga magulang dahil nga po sa kahirapan. So kung ako po ay papalarin bilang Ginoong Pilipinas, gagamitin ko po ang karangalan na ito at kausapin ko po ang matataas na opisyales ng ating gobyerno na tulungan nila ako ng isang katuparan pagtulong sa mga bata nito.
Last question about that. Okay, I'll choose Mr. Cagayan Valley, Cebu, Bulacan, Osamis, Masbate.
Madami na ba?
Sandali lang. Wait lang kayo. Okay, no? Si, ay hindi pa, Batangas, Las Piñas, Cavite. 10 na ba yan? Hindi pa. Sandali ah. Patingin ng mga tabig. Oh, sige, ilan na kayo? 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay.
Dalawa pa.
Gusto ko 8 lang. Phone question ng mga tita sa pageantry ni Briggs, ni Amir, ni
Hindi. Bago niyo sagutin yung, okay. Two-level question. What have you accomplished in your studies? Then, as a future, if you become a father, if your son would ask you, Dad, anong mas mahalaga? Magkaroon ng maging title holder or matapos ko ang studies ko? What would you tell them?
So far, I find education very important. That is why I've been taking up two courses, which is one of aviation, as well as I am currently a senior psychology student, which I aim to finish this March. So yes, I find education very important. And to answer your question, well, I would tell my son someday if I were a father that if you look at how I've done it, I was able to balance two courses together with joining pageants, so why not do both? If you're able to find the time and put the effort, then why not? Because if you're just dedicated enough, you'll be able to do both anyways. But if you really have to choose one, then you can always finish your studies and pursue pageantry as soon as you graduate. So that would be my idea.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening. I am the graduate of Bachelor of Science in Psychology from Pagani State University. Yes, and for me, it's more important. Is the most important is education. Finishing a degree can already prove that you have the title. Thank you.
Good evening again, everyone. For me, if given a chance to be a father, and my son asked me if what will I choose. What he will choose.
Yes, what is more important. Yes.
What is important. For me, I will tell him that to choose education first. Because me, I graduated as an HRM, and now I'm here in front of you, pursuing my passion and pursuing my dream to be as like, Filipinas. That's it.
Okay, thank you. I will be just direct. My answer is, I will choose this study first because yun nga mas mahalaga yung pag-aaral kaysa sa mga anong bagay na mas maganda. Tsaka yun. Thank you.
Good evening. If ever po na ako ay maging tatay, I will say to my son that, son, life isn't easy. Please do your studies, do your education po, education muna. Because wala akong may ibang may pakumana sa'yo, kundi ang education, and ang edukasyon ang dadalhin mo agad sa pagtanda. And I believe that education is the key for success. Thank you.
So, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So, I'm Lorenzo Isip. I'm a tourism management student and a member of basketball varsity team in Cebu. So, if ever in the future I will have a son and ask me what's more important, the pageantry or education, I will advise him that first I will tell him my experience as a self-supporting student because I support my own study because I'm a product of a broken family. My dad left us and my mom can send me in college to get a business. So I'm doing both worlds, my education and pageantry for 3 years. I experienced having a title but it doesn't prevent me from going to school. So why would I like what Cebu said, like what would I choose between two if I can do both? It's very hard for someone to be to choose for her career or for her passion if he loves doing both. So as long as we have the determination, we have the courage, and we are hardworking, of course we are passionate about the things we love to do, then anything is possible as long as we do things in a good way. Thank you.
I choose education dahil ako po'y naniniwala na ang edukasyon ang susi sa ating tagumpay. Maraming salamat.
For me, I'll also go for education because with proper education, you can never go wrong. And for me, I'm interior design, graduated in United Arab Emirates. And at the age of 22, I managed to put up my own business in SM Center, in SM Las Piñas. So if you have proper education and you're well-rounded, everything is possible if you believe in yourself. And the advice I could give to my son would be believe in yourself, finish education, and you only live once, follow your passion. Thank you.
Good evening. If he asked me, I would say him that choose education because it's something that can take away from you. And if you want to join pageant, let him finish first his studies. Thank you.
Okay. So that wraps up our open mic session. Whenever you leave something open, really. Now we are about to announce the winner of our Darling of the Press as voted upon. So the name will before we announce. Darling of the Press, Nadine, would you do the honors, please?
Darling of the Press is Sebu.
Anong height ni Sebu? 6'3".
Ay, happy ni ano. Norman, Norman, iba ang ngiti.
Later solo. Later solo.
Congratulations, Rick Lynn and Mr., the future pilot. And before we wrap things up, our favorite lady of Corotel Irish Spring will announce the winner of the overnight stay here at Coro Hotel. The hotel I'd love to stay in the future because it's so nice. I will be also given the opportunity in the future, Irish Spring. I love the breakfast too, it's extra large meals. Yeah, extra large meals,
XL
meals. My God, the first winner is...
Ay! Ay!
Balik! Kakaloko naman yun.
Balik!
Parang ayaw mabunod yata. Kasi naman, hindi mabunod eh. Tuloy mo ko siya, big nuances. The next, ito, room only accommodations in one of their well-appointed units upstairs, which is very old, with a very firm bed that will make you sleep at night very well. Jenny Summit. Okay. Please, pag nanalo po kayo ng breakfast, room, tapos pag in-avail nyo na, please try na din sa social media with the hashtag Coro Hotel. Tag na rin ang Coro Hotel, please. Yes. Ay, ito maganda. Room accommodation with breakfast for two at extra large each. Raul Barake? Sino daw isasama mo? Ay naman, just ko naman. Irish
Spring.
Yeah, so next time,
I'm going
to Okay. So let me remind you again of the pool party tomorrow with the Filipino Scandalous happening at the pool area of Coro Hotel 17th floor starting at 8:30 p.m. Right, man? 8 p.m. Tickets are available. You can either get a cabana or a table, or just join the party and you will have fun. You will meet and greet the Ginoos. And there will also be the national costume on Saturday. And national costume and formal wear on Saturday before the finals on Sunday, where four of you will be the winners. Thank you so much for attending. And if you just want to have photos with you know, individually, just approach them and no problem. Yeah, if you want to ask photos with them. I'm saying. Yeah. So we're now finished. So our Ginoos can start mingling with members of the press now. I told you, walang wallpaper dito. At lalo walang wallflower.